Hello guys, welcome to Mathematical Bridge channel. So this channel will help you in your preparation for pre-RMO and other mathematical exam. So today we are going to solve some number theory problems which will be helpful for pre-RMO, KUPAP and other competitive exams. So let's start. So the question one is, find the sum of all positive integers such that 3n minus 4, 4n minus 5 and 5n minus 3 all primes. So basically this means that, so if P1, so we let 3n minus 4 to be P1, which is a prime, and 5n minus 3 to be P3. So P1 plus P3 would be equal to, you can calculate this, so you will get that 3n plus 5n, 8n, 8n minus 7. So 8n minus 7. So this right here, 8n is even. So even minus an odd number. So we'll get that 8n minus 7 is an odd number. So this means that the sum of these two primes, P1 and P3, is an odd number. But so this means that one of them has to be odd and other has to be even. So this means that one of the prime is even. But we know that only even prime is 2. So this means that 3n minus 4 is equal to 2, or 5n minus 3 is equal to 2. So this means that n is equal to 2 or n is equal to 1. So if n is equal to 2, we'll substitute n. If n is equal to 2, so we'll get these solutions 2, 3, 7. And if n is 1, then we'll get these solutions minus 1, minus 1, 2, and my negative numbers are not prime numbers. So this is rejected. So our only solution is 2. So sum of all positive integers such that 3n minus 4. So the answer would be 2. Simple question. So let's move on to our second question, which is, for how many n belonging to natural numbers such that n factorial has 2020 trailing zeros? So 2020 trailing zeros means the number in the end would have 2020 zeros, like this. So number would be something, and in the end there would be 2020 zeros. So basically this means that number is divisible by 10 raised to 2020. It has 2020 as its factor. So this means that 5 raised to 2020 is its factor. So this means that the number n factorial would have the maximum power to be 2 raised to 2020. And the power of 2 would be greater than this number, because for example, let's say 5 factorial is equal to 120. So 120 is equal to, so the power of 5 here is 1, and the power, the exponent which is there is greater than this because it is 2 in cube. So always the power of 2, exponent of 2 raised to something, would always be greater. So this need not be calculated. So we will calculate the power of 5 and n factorial using Legendre's formula. So we know that power of 5 is 2020 from our argument. So the Legendre formula states that gif of n by 5 dot 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 gif of n by 5 raised to something. So 5 raised to something is less than n. And GIF is basically, for example, let's say 1.2. So GIF of 1.2 would be 1. So it is the least integer less than the number. So now we notice that gif of n by phi is less than the number because we can clearly see this. Because gif of 1.2, gif of 1.2 is equal to 1. So basically this means that n by phi, so the number, so the gif is gif, here is our gif value and this is the number. So 1 is less than 1.2. So similarly, n by phi is less, so the number is less than the gif of it. So similarly, we'll add all these numbers. So n by phi dot 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 plus n by phi raised to x for some x would be less than, wait a minute. So gif of a number is less than the number. So this expression right here would be less than this expression, which is this n by phi plus dot 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 plus n by phi raised to x, because the gif of a number is less than the number. So now this expression you will use gp here. So we'll take n common here, n bracket 1 by phi dot 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 plus 1 by phi raised to x, and x is very large because n has 2 zeros, so x is also very large. So we'll use gp here formula. So n 1 upon phi a upon 1 minus r. So we'll calculate this, so we'll get it around n by 4. So you use gp and we get it equal to n by 4. So this means that this expression is n by 4, approximately n by 4. So this means that 2020 is less than n by 4. So this means that n has to be greater than 8080. So we'll now put, let's say if n for n is equal to 8080, a solution is possible. So let's first put n is equal to 8080 in our equation. So we'll get that it has 2017. So it has 5 raised to 207 as its factor. So now we need a number. So the number n which we need for n factorial to have 2020 is clear, will be clearly greater than 8080. And we also know that it should have a factor 5. So if we multiply 8081 into 8080 factorial, then there will be no change in the power of 5 because this is not divisible by 5. And thus the power. So 8081 factorial will have maximum power of 5. We'll have 5 is to 207 is its factor only, and there will be no change in the exponent. And so we'll check this. So we'll get that 8085 has a factor. So 8085 factorial would have factor, would have 2018 factor power of 5. And similarly, we'll check this. So we'll have see that V5 of 8085 is, so the maximum power of 5 dividing 8085 is 1. And similarly we'll check V5 of 8090 is 1. So the maximum power of 5 dividing 8090 is 1. And similarly, V5 of 8095 is equal to 1. So we see that we'll add these three powers. So we'll get that 809 factorial will have, so 207 plus 3. 2020 maximum power. So this means that 8095 is the least number satisfying our condition. And now if we'll check, so we see that 8096 factorial, 8097 factorial, 8098 factorial, 80 do not have any powers of 5. So 8096 into 809 factorial, nothing would change of the exponent. Similarly, 8097, similarly 8098, 8099. But what would, when it would be 8100, So when it would be 8100 factorial, then this number is divisible by 5. So this means that 8100 into 8099 factorial. Now this has maximum power 5 is 2 0, and this has maximum power to be 5 square. So then our expression would be 5 raised to 2022. So the number of trailing zeros would change for after 8099. So our answer would be 8095, 8096, 8097. So there are 5 such numbers. So the answer would be 5. So let's move on to our next question. So our question is, find all 4-digit numbers, find the number of 4-digit numbers so which have sum of the digits to be equal to 18. So let the number be ABCD. This is a number. So let our number be ABCD equal to N number. And now we know that ABCD is 1000 A plus 100 B plus 10 C plus D. And if you will notice that if you subtract the sum of digits from this, minus A plus B plus C plus D is equal to 999 A plus 99 B plus 9 C, which is clearly divisible by 9. And we are given that A plus B plus C plus D is 18. So ABCD minus 18 is divisible by 9. So this means that ABCD also has to be divisible by 9. So this means that there are 1000 numbers, 4-digit numbers such, because 1008 is the least such number. And 9 into 112. And up till 9 into 1111. So this means there would be 1111 minus 112 plus 1. So there will be 1000 such numbers divisible by 9. And we see that there are 4 categories of such numbers. Numbers which are sum of digits as 9, others with sum of digits 18, sum of digits 27, with sum of digits 36. And there are no 4-digit numbers with sum digits 46, 45, because the maximum digit possible, the value of the digit maximum possible is 9. So if all are 9, then the maximum possible sum of digits can be 9 plus 9 plus 9 equal to 36. The maximum sum of digits can only be 36. That's why there are only 4 categories. So if case 1 sum of digits is 36, it's possible only when number is 9999. And this is because all have to be 9, then only maximum would be achieved. And case 2 is sum of digits 9. So A plus B plus C plus D is equal to 9. So if A is equal to 1, B plus C plus D would be equal to 8. And if B is equal to 0, there will be 9 such ordered pairs, because 8, so C, comma D would be 8, comma 0, 7, comma 1, and up till, this will go on up till 0, comma 8. So there will be 9 such numbers or ordered pairs. What else? Similarly, B is equal to 1, there will be 8 such ordered pairs. And so this pattern will continue, and thus we'll get 9 plus 8 plus 7 dot 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 plus 1 is equal to 45. So we'll directly use the formula here. N into N plus 1 by 2, 9 into 10 by 2 is equal to 45. Now, if A is equal to 2, B plus C plus D is equal to 7, And similarly, the same logic we used, which was if b is equal to 9, so sigma 9 dot 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 plus 1. So now if here a is equal to 2, so there will be a b plus c plus d is equal to 7. So we'll have 7 plus 1, 8, and 8 plus 7 dot 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 plus 1. So this pattern would continue. So if a is equal to 2, we'll have 36 such ordered pairs. B plus C plus D is equal to 6, there will be 7 into 8 by 2, 28. And similarly, for A is equal to 4, we will have 15, if A is equal to 1, so on. So therefore, we will have, in case 1, the number of such numbers possible would be 45 plus 36 plus 28. And if you know that these are basically triangular numbers, so the sum of first 9 triangular numbers would be 165. And now case 3 is a plus b plus c plus d is equal to 27. So if a is equal to 1, then b plus c plus d would be 26. There is a slight change here. So if as c plus d is less than equal to 18, b has to be greater than equal to c plus d is less than equal to 18 because maximum C can be 9 and D can also be maximum be 9. So C plus D is less than equal to 18. C is equal to 9, D is equal to 9. C less than equal to 9, D less than equal to 9. So C plus D is less than 18. And thus, if C plus D is less than equal to 18, B has to be greater than equal to 8. If B is equal to 8, we'll get C plus D is equal to 18. So 9 and 9, one solution only possible. And if B is equal to 9, we'll get C plus D is equal to 17. B is equal to 9, C plus D is equal to 17. So C comma D would be 8 comma 9 and 9 comma 8. So these are our two solutions here. And if B is equal to 9, then we will have C plus D is equal to 16. So in case A is equal to 1, and now, so in case 1, we will have 1 plus 2, 3 solutions. And now if A is equal to 2, then B would be greater than equal to 7. So if B is equal to 7, C plus D is equal to 18, one solution. And B is equal to 8, we have already calculated this. So C plus D is equal to 17, two solutions. And now C plus D is equal to 16, we will have three solutions, which are 8 comma 8, C comma D is equal to 8 comma 8, 7 comma 9, and 9 comma 7. So we can again notice a similar pattern here, which is of triangular numbers. So in case 1, we had 1 plus 2, 3 solutions. In case A is equal to 2, we are having 1 plus 2 plus 3, 6 solutions. So similarly, in case A is equal to 3, so here's the pattern. If A is equal to 1, we have 1 plus 2 solutions. If A is equal to 2, we have 1 plus 2 plus 3 solutions. If A is equal to 3, we have 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 solutions. So, for A is equal to 9, we'll have A is equal to 9, we'll have 1 plus 2 plus 3 dot 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 plus 10. So, 10 into 11 by 2. So, basically, we have to calculate sum of first 10 triangular numbers. And if you'll calculate this, that you will get your answer to be 220 and we have also a calculation hack to do this. There is a formula for this. So it is k into k plus 1 into 2k plus 1 by 6, which you will learn in algebra. 10 into 11 into 21 divided by 6. sum of first 10 triangular numbers. N into 11 by 2, so you get to be 55, and we have already calculated here for 9 into 10 by 2, so we have got this equal to 165. 1 plus 3 plus 4 plus 6 plus 10, 20, 35, 56, 28, 84, 120, 165. And for this one, we'll have 155. Oh, so this will be 9 into 10 into 19 divided by 6. A1 is equal to 1 plus 2, 1 plus 2 plus 3. So 3. What am I missing here? 3, 6, 10, and up till 55. So 10 into 11 by 2, 55. We'll have this to be 10 into 11 into 21 by 6. Three plus six plus 10. Plus 15 up till 55, and we have already calculated this one here. 1 plus 3 plus 6 plus 10 plus 15 plus 21 plus 28 plus 36 plus 45, which is 165. So we need to basically calculate 165. 3 plus 6 A is equal to K, so we have K plus 1 into K plus 2 by 2 solutions. So we'll have 2 2 0, minus 1, we will have 219 solutions. So we'll calculate from 1 plus 3 plus 6 dot 55. So we'll get this expression to be 220, and 220 minus 1 is 219. So there are 219 solutions. And thus case 4, we have total numbers 1000, which are divisible by 9, minus 1, which is sum of 36, and minus 219 minus 165. So we will have 615 such numbers possible. This should be changed to 615. So now let's move on to the third question, fourth question, which is, what is the sum of all possible positive integers n such that mod of 2 raised to n plus 7 raised to n minus 57 is a perfect square? So what we are going to assume first is that we are going to let n to be greater than or equal to 2. And so If n is odd, we'll have 2 raised to n plus 7 raised to n minus 57 is greater than 0 for n is greater than or equal to 3. We can clearly see this because 7 cube is 343, which is clearly greater than 57. So this R expression is clearly greater. And we know that 7 raised to n is congruent to 3 mod 4. So why this is happening is because 7 is odd and we have assumed n to be odd. So if you will you will check this, that an odd raised to an odd number is leaves a remainder 3 on division by 4. So 2 raised to n for n greater than equal to 3 would be divisible by 4. Therefore we will have, so we'll add all the remainders on division by 4. So this has remainder on a division by 4 to be 0, because for n greater than or equal to 2, it is divisible by 4, 2 raised to n. And 7 raised to n, we have calculated to 2 be 3. And minus 57 would be minus 1. So if all numbers are calculated on remainder on division by 4, we'll see that this whole expression would leave remainder on division by 4 to be 2. And this is not possible because q square is 4k plus 2. And if so, this means that this is an even number. So q also has to be an even number because it cannot be odd. And but if it would be an even number, so let q be 2 into l. So if we'll take the whole squares, q square would be equal to 4l square. So this would mean that 4 divides q square, which is not, which we are not getting because it leaves a remainder on 2 on division by 4. So this this is a contradiction. So n for n, so when n is odd, we'll have no solutions. And if n is even, then we'll have that 7 raised to k whole square plus 4k raised to k minus 57 is greater than 0 for n greater than or equal to 3. And q square is 7 raised to k whole square plus 4 raised to k minus 57. And we also know that 4 cube is 64. So 64 minus 57 is greater than 0. So 4 raised to k minus 57 is greater than 0. And so q is greater than or equal to 7 raised to k plus 1. So this means that q square is greater than or equal to 7 raised to 2k plus 2, 2 into 7 raised to k plus 1, which is greater than 7 raised to k whole square, 7 raised to 2k. These are both are equal. And so 7 raised to, so 7 is greater than 4. So the power of k, 7 raised to the power of k will be greater than equal to greater than 4k. And so the, if even if we multiply 2 to 7 raised to k, so the inequality would not change. It would still be greater than 4 raised to k. And if this, if it is greater than 4 raised to k, it is greater than 4 raised to k, then it would be obviously greater than 2 into 7 raised to k, greater than 4 raised to k minus 57. So 2 into 7 raised to k plus 1 would also be greater than 4 raised to k minus 57. I hope you got it. So thus we have a size contradiction because q square is greater than our expression. So thus there exists no solution for n is equal to 3. So we'll check it. For n is equal to 3, we'll have 2 cube plus 7 cube minus 57. 343 plus 8, 351 minus 57, we'll get it to be 294. Which is not a perfect square. And if we'll check for, we'll check for n is equal to 2 now. N is equal to 1, first we'll check. So 2 plus 1 is 9, 9 minus 57 minus 48, and mod of this is 48. So it is not a perfect square. And if we'll now check it for 2, so we'll get that 2 square, 2 square plus 7 square minus 57 is equal to minus 4 and mod of minus 4 is equal to 4, which is 2 square. Thus, n is equal to 2 is our least solution, is our only solution, and the sum of all positive integer n would be 2. 2 is our answer. Now, this is a very interesting question, and also P by Q of pre-RMU. So, find the smallest prime number P such that P cubed. This should be cube here, so don't get confused. So, P cubed plus 4P square plus 4P have exactly 30 positive divisors. So, we'll assume P to be greater than 3. So, we'll first factorize this. So, we'll get that P, it is P into, so we'll take P common here. P square, so in bracket we'll get it to be P square plus 4P plus 4. And now you'll notice this, it is a square of P plus 2, P plus 2 whole square. Now, GCD of P plus 2, so GCD is basically the greatest common divisor. And for example, let's say, and P is an odd number because it is greater than 3. For example, let's say 3, 5. These both are don't have any common factor, so their GCD is 1. And here we have assumed that P is odd. We have proved P is odd because it is greater than 3. So 5, 7. So in all cases, we'll get that P of np plus 2 GCD would be 1 for P to be odd. And as P is odd, so D of P into P plus 2 whole square. So D is basically the number of divisors. So D is basically the number of divisors here. So if N is a number, P1 raised to alpha 1, dot 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 Pn. So these are primes. So there are N primes in its factorization, and these are the exponents. For example, let's say 80. So 80 is equal to 2 raised to 4 into 5. So these are basically the primes and these are the powers. So in general, for a number greater than 1, this is we can write it in this form to get the factors of the number. So D of P into P plus 2 whole square. So as we know that P and P2 are co-primes, so this means that no common prime divides these both numbers. So this means that P is P only, and P plus 2 whole square. So let P plus 2 be something, let's say it is a it has factorization of some primes. So let me P1 raised to alpha 1, P2 raised to alpha 2, dot dot dot, Pn raised to alpha n. So now P plus 2 whole square would be P1 raised to 2 alpha 1, dot 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 Pn raised to 2 alpha n. Simple. So now the product of these both expressions would be P into P plus 2 whole square. So P is a totally different prime here. It is not equal to any of these P1 dot dot Pn. So now, if you will, if you are familiar with this number of divisors formula, so you will get it. So you will get it to be number of divisors of D. So D of number of divisors. Number of divisors would be 2 into 2 alpha plus 1 dot 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 2 alpha n plus 1. Simple. So this means that 2a1 dot dot would be equal to 15, because here we have 2. So this 2 would be, and we have been given in the question, it is number of divisors 30. 2 would be cancelled from both sides. So this expression would be equal to 15. So 2a1 plus 1 dot 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 2an plus 1 is equal to 15. And as ai is, so the exponents are greater than 1, because the if it is 0, then it would make it would not make sense. So if there are more so if there are more than three exponents, then we know that each number is greater than or equal to 1. So 2a1 is greater than equal to 2. 2a1 plus 1 is greater than equal to 3. So if there are three primes in the factorization of a number p plus 2 whole square, then we will have 3 cube. So there would be greater than 27, which is not possible because we have given our expression is 15. So which this leads to contradiction. So there are only 2 or 1 primes in the factorization of p plus 2 whole square. And if there are 1, we will have 2a1 plus 1 is equal to 15. So a1 would be equal to 7. So p would be p1. So it is a different prime. p1 raised to 7 is a totally different prime. And p1 raised to 7 minus 2. Now, p is odd, because we have assumed p to be odd. So p is odd. So odd plus even number is also odd. So p1 is also odd. So p1 minimum is 3. So p would also be minimum equal to 3 raised to 7 minus 2. And 3 raised to 7 is a very large number. So p has to be p will be a very large number. And we do not need this because we need to find smallest. So let's check another case where exponent is 2. So if there are 2 primes in the factorization, so 2a1 plus 1, 2a2 plus 1 would be 15. And as 15 is equal to 3 into 5, we can clearly see a1 is equal to 1, a2 is equal to 2. So p would be equal to p1 into p2 whole square minus 2 for some p1 and p2 that are primes. And as p is odd, we'll have p1, p2 square also odd. And so none of them is equal to 2. So p2 is minimum 3 and p1 is minimum 5. And so to minimize p1, p2 square, we'll put p2 equal to 3 and p1 equal to 5. We can, and if we'll check that if it is, so we'll get it to be 3 square into 5, 45. So p is equal to 43. And if we'll check it for the other way around, so we'll get that p2 is equal to 5 and p1 is equal to 3. So you will get it to be 75 and P would be 73. P would be 73 and which is greater than 43, and we need the smallest prime. So thus 43 is our answer. Let's move on to our next question, which is for each N belonging to N, let DN denote GCD of N and 2017 minus n. So find the value of s of d1 plus d2 dot dot d27. Sk denotes the digital sum of k. So digital sum is basically, for example, let's say 371. So for what is the process? Basically, we have to calculate the sum of digits of the number repeatedly. So S of 371 would be, sum of digits of 371 would be 11. And now we have to calculate again the sum of digits of this number. So it would be 2. So we have to repeat this process again and again until we get a unit digit. And so let's start our solution. So if GCD of n and 2017 minus n is equal to d, d is a number. So this means that d divides n and d also has to divide 2017 minus n. So we'll add these both. So this means that d divides n, the sum of the two numbers, it will also divide. So d divides n plus 2017 minus n. So d divides 2017. And Unfortunately, 2017 is prime, so we'll have D to be equal to 1 or 2017. And for D to be 2017, N also. So for D is 2017, then we'll have N is equal to 2017 into something. Let's say it is alpha. And we have given, and we need to only, we have given that N is less than 2017 because we need to only calculate it D 2017. So if N is equal to 2017, then it would mean that we have to calculate GCD of 2017 and 2017 and 0. And GCD of 2017 and 0 is not possible. It is, does not make any sense. So we will have that. So this means that all other numbers D1, D2 until D2016 are not divisible by 2017. This means that they all will not have GCD to be 2017. This means they all will have GCD equal to 1. So D1 is equal to D2 dot 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 is equal to D2016 would be equal to 1. So sum would be 2016. And now S of 2016 is 9. 2 plus 1 plus 6 is 9. Thus, 9 is our digital root sum, whatever you need to call it. So let's move on to our next question, which is very simple. Let M be the least positive integer divisible by 13 whose digits sum to 13. Find SM where SK denotes the digital sum of K. So now let we know that the number is M. So we are given in the question S of M is equal to 13. And we have need to calculate the digital root. So basically we'll calculate S of 13. So we'll get it to be 4. Digital root would be 4. Simple question. So you need not calculate the least positive integer, which is divisible by 13, whose digit sum to 13. You can directly calculate. It would come out to be 4 because we need to basically calculate the digital sum. So this is an interesting question, which is an RMO PYQ. So find the number of natural solutions to the following equality, which is sigma a plus I cubed is equal to sigma b plus I raised to 4. It is blah, blah, blah. It is. So this basically means that a plus 1 whole cube plus a plus 2 whole cube plus a plus 6 whole cube is equal to b raised to 4 plus b plus 1 raised to 4. Now there is an interesting formula, which is that sum of the first n cubes, natural n cubes, is sigma n whole square, and sigma n is basically the sum 1 plus 2 plus dot 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 n. So sigma n cube is basically it means that 1 plus 2 dot 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 plus n whole square is equal to 1 cube plus 2 cube dot 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 plus n cube. So I think you will now understand where I'm going with this. So sigma a plus 6 whole cube is a plus 6 into a plus 7 by 2 whole square. And so now LHS would be equal to sigma a plus 6 whole cube minus sigma a minus 1 whole cube. It should be a minus 1. Why? Because if you use some algebra here. So we need to basically calculate a cube plus a plus 6 cube, a cube dot 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 plus a plus 6 whole cube. And so a plus 6 cube dot 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 plus 1 cube, if we subtract this with minus 1 cube minus a minus 1 whole cube dot 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 plus 1 cube, this all would cancel, and up till a minus 1 it would cancel, and thus we'll get a cube plus dot 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 plus a plus 6 whole cube. I hope you got it. So this would basically mean that a plus 6 into a plus 7 by 2 whole square minus a minus 1 into a by 2 whole square. So if you will factorize this, a plus 6 into a plus 7 plus a minus 1 a divided by 2 into a plus 6 into a plus 7 minus a minus 1 into a divided by 2. You will use the formula a square plus b square minus a square minus b square identity. So if you will calculate this, you will get it to be a square plus 13a plus 42 plus a square minus a. 2a square plus 14a plus 42 divided by 2 would be 8 square plus 7a plus 21 a plus 6 into a plus 7 minus a minus 1 divided by 4 now. Square plus 13a plus 42a square minus a. 2a square plus 12a plus 42 it would be. So a square plus 6a plus 21 you will get it here in this first bracket. This first bracket would be equal to a square plus 6a plus 21. Second bracket come out to be minus a square plus a name. So a square plus 13a plus 42 minus a square plus a. A square plus a. This would cancel off. So 14a plus 42. Divided by 2 would be 7a plus 21. Second bracket would be 7a plus 21. And if you will take 7 as common, you will get it to be 7 into. So thus, we'll calculate after a long calculations, we'll finally get it to be 7 into a plus 3 into a square plus 6a plus 21. So this means that our LHS is divisible by 7. So if it seven divides LHS, so this means that seven should also divide RHS. So this means that seven divides b raised to 4 plus b one plus b plus 1 raised to 4. So now this means that seven divides sum of two perfect square. So b square whole square plus b plus 1 whole square whole square. So this means that 7 is divisible, so sum of 2 squares is divisible by 7. And now what we are going to show by contradiction is that it is not divisible by 7. So we'll draw a column here, so let a number q square. So if a number leaves a remainder 1 on division by 7, then its perfect square would leave remainder on division by 7 to be 1. So for example, 8 square is 64 and 8 leaves a remainder 1 on division by 7, and let's say what the remainder, what its square leaves the remainder. So it is 64 and 7 into 9 plus 1, 63 plus 1. So it leaves 1 as remainder on division by 7. For example, similarly 2. So 7k plus 2 whole square. So let's say 9 square. 9 square is 81. 7 into 11 plus 3. 77 plus 3. 77 plus 4, sorry. This would be 4. Similarly, you will calculate this. So 3. So the remainder on division by q square would be If the number leaves the remainder on division by 7, 4, then its remainder will be 16. So 16 is basically 2 mod 7. If it leaves 5, then 5 square 25. 4, 6, 1, 0, 0. So now, this means that the number leaves either 1, 4, 2 or 0 as remainder on division by 7. The perfect square leaves either 1, either 4 or 2 or 0 on division by 7. So if these both numbers are not divisible by 7, b and b plus 1 both are not divisible by 7. Then our perfect square would leave either 1, 2, 4 mod 7. So let's say, so b raised to 4 would leave either 1, 2 or 4 mod 7. Then this means for 7 to divide RHS, b plus 1 raised to 4. So if our perfect square leaves 1 as remainder, then it would have to leave 7 minus 1, 6 as remainder. Similarly, if it leaves 2, then it would have to leave b plus 1 raised to 4 would have to leave 5 as remainder. And so 6, 5, 3, but this is also a perfect square, and we have shown that a perfect square can only leave 1, 2, 4 or 0 as a remainder. So this leads to contradiction, which is not possible. So now this means that if 7 does not divide b, then we have no solution. So let's say if 7 divides b, so if 7 divides b, then we will have that 7 does not divide b plus 1. So this would mean that 7 does not divide b. If let's say 7 divides b, so then it would mean that 7 does not divide b plus 1. For example, 7 is divisible by 7. But 8 is not, unfortunately, not divisible by 7. So if 7 does not divide b plus 1, then 7 cannot divide b plus 1 raised to 4. So, and 7, we know that 7 divides b raised to 4. But if 7 divides b raised to 4, but it does not divide b plus 1 raised to 4, then that sum would not be divisible by 7. And thus, in all cases, 7 does not divide the RHS. Thus, there exists no solution to our equation. I hope you like the video, and please hit the subscribe button, and please share this video, and you can join our Telegram channel for these amazing questions. Thank you.